Good afternoon and welcome to another special in-house edition of your number one favorite program, Gender Equality, right here at SIGTV. And remember that this program is brought to you courtesy of the Massey Lee Foundation. And today on the show, we have a very, very special guest. Yeah, she's special, right? We have the sport juggernaut. We are not talking sport right now, but she will be talking a very, very interesting and sensitive topic with us. Omolabake, how do you feel not talking sport right about now?
I feel good. I mean, I do other things other than sport. So, guys, thank you so much. Yes, please. I do other things.
All right, guys. that's our guest on the show, Omolabake. You know her on the sport program, sport analysis, right? On today's program, we'll be talking about a very, very delicate issue that people don't want to talk about. Don't let me say people. A lot of people don't want to talk about, right? Because they say when they talk about it, the reception they receive, the attitude they get after saying what they say has not been very good, and they want to keep their mouth short. Alright, so these are more we're going to talk about on this show today, gender equality. I'm not going to let the cat right out of the bag right about now. So let me just tell you that to be a part of the show, you're wondering, you want to drop a comment, you want to drop your opinion, your thoughts right on the show. All you need to do is follow us on all our media social platforms, right? On Facebook, on Twitter, Instagram, TikTok, and YouTube. It's a CTV Live, right? For TikTok, it is CTV Live 1, while the rest of the channels is CTV Live, right? So that's the handles where you get to follow us and watch all of our amazing content where we deliver. All right, so guys, we've heard, like they said, that there's a new virus in town. Omolabake, do you want to tell us about this new virus in town?
COVID Omicron is it, and as a matter of fact, I'm done with COVID, but COVID isn't done with us yet. So guys, make sure you mask up, wash your hands properly, and go and get vaccinated if you're not.
All right, so yet. Have you been vaccinated?
Yes, sir. Absolutely, yeah.
Like the
two jabs.
Two jabs.
No, not that kind. You don't have to be physical now. No, not that kind of jab. Just, yeah.
All right, guys. So if you've not gotten your vaccine, we plead with you to go get your vaccine so that you know, that the way it helps with reducing.
It bolsters your immune system, basically, and makes you able to
attack and entry into your system. And all right, guys. So stay safe, right? We are very particular about safety right here at CTV. You drive a car, you don't drive a car, everybody please stay safe. Don't let us say long story. We don't like long stories right here. All right, so now we get right into the show, Omolabake. So guys, the topic for today is called rape. That's what we want to talk about. That's what we want to break down. Like, we want to
open
our minds to this issue, because a lot of people don't want to talk about it. A lot of people don't want to. A lot of people feel shy about this matter, especially for the victims that we actually like to call survivors, right, on this issue. They don't want to talk about it. So we want to open up everybody's mind on this issue. Omolabake, do you want to help us with what?
Absolutely. Rape is basically forced, non-consensual sex. That's basically it. Intercourse that consent is not given. It's usually because the victim, or in this case the survivor, is scared of harm, or you are perhaps overpowered. That basically is what rape is. Yeah, the opposite of consensual sex.
All right, so basically is having to have canon knowledge of a person without the person agreeing to, you know, do the same with you, or having to, you know, wanting to do what you want to do with them. So that's basically what rape is all about, right? And a lot of people, you just, I want to imagine how they have that process taught in their minds. You meet somebody, especially when it happens with a stranger, somebody you don't know, you've not met before, you, let's say you met recently, and because you say that the person is giving you the green light per se, right? Somebody you met him, she's smiling at me, right? And she our body touched, then I felt like she's giving me signs.
Yeah, I mean, that's wild. I mean, that particular statement to me is so wild, it's so crazy, to say the very least. What does green light mean? We're not talking about traffic here, it's not traffic light. The simple thing is to ask. If you're feeling someone like that, ask. Have a conversation. That's the that's the difference between being an adult, really, and being a kid. Ask, talk. There's no such thing. I don't think there's any such thing as green light. Of course, there are certain kind of cues, non-verbal cues. But the question is, that can be misconstrued. It can be misinterpreted. The fact that a guy or a lady laughs at your joke does not mean they find you attractive or want you like that. The fact that someone smiles at you or perhaps touches you when they're talking to you or keeps their eyes on you. I mean, if I'm talking to you, where am I supposed to be looking at? If you're talking, if you say something for me, am I supposed to... That's no, we can't keep having this particular kind of responses and excuses, so to speak, for why certain people rape. Yeah, exactly. Ask. That's it. Ask.
We've heard a lot of cases whereby you hear the rapist say that it's because of how she was dressed, it's because of how she exposed a certain part of her body. That is why I did what I did. Are we saying that, and a lot of people tend to defend this, like, it's true. Look at the way she's dressed. Look at how she exposed the upper part of her body. I mean,
the skirt was too short. And
do you understand? A lot, we need to really tackle this.
So I personally think that it's just an excuse and a silly one at that, because most mad people that roam the streets, which is not so common anymore in Lagos, thank God, most mentally not okay people who walk or roam around the streets, most times are usually naked. Or certain the clothes not covering certain part of their body. For the male, for the female, for most of the male I see, it's been a long time, but they walk stark naked. The females, maybe a top that is torn, blouse. How come these people don't get aroused when you see people like this? How come you don't get you don't have this urge to rape when you see people like this? But then you see someone wearing a certain kind of clothing, which is quote and unquote indecent. See, that we've got to understand something. That's the point. It's your body, and the person has the right to dress however they want to dress. All right. Of course, they are societally acceptable form of clothing. True, but you find that this rapist actually rape people who are covered from head to toe, from like people that you actually don't see with what the color of their skin at all. They still get raped.
Babies.
How does a baby seduce you? How does a child, like a baby, how does that arouse you? How
madness, to say the least.
That's the word for it. I mean, it's a silly excuse. Consequence management, I think, is the way to go. If there are consequences for certain actions,
because we've seen cases where a rapist get away with what he has done, because when you take this kind of things to court, right, you see the defending lawyer laying a lot of claims, like, bring out the clothes you were putting on, how did he do it, that kind of question, what were you wearing, how did he go about it, things that will, you know, trying to bring back, you know, let's say a victim was raped, right, one of the things she's trying to work on is, I believe, for one, is that she wants to forget the scene of what happened, right, now we want to get justice for her, or for whoever got raped. Now we go to court, and now the defending lawyer is asking, now come outside and narrate your side of the story, like the unsettling thing in our mind, and we're trying to push it up out again. I mean, what she's trying to forget. Now, looking at those kind of things that the lawyers will throw at her, what the media will say, what people will say. Was she, like you said, that, you know, we have a way we want people to dress in the society. What people say about her dressing? Was she dressed right? Was she not dressed right? What was she doing at the place where? Because even police will ask you, what were you doing in a certain place at a certain time? These are questions that you might want to think again. Do I want to go through all of this stress, all of this trauma, just to get justice? Because what has happened, right?
Right, what has happened. But that's the part where consequence management does come in for me. I think that if we're able to make the laws as stringent and we actually follow it to the letter, it's going to be quite hard for someone to boldly, proudly actually say, because you find in young, I know male boys get raped, girls get raped, right? But it's more prevalent with the ladies, right? More ladies get raped. You find a group of guys in their early 20s, perhaps late teens, having conversations of, yes, I did, with so much pride. Confident. You wouldn't do that if there was a consequence, if you know that you're going to get punished. You're going to get punished really hard for this. Like, and that's the part. We should stop paying lip service as a people, as a community, as a society. We need to start from us. Don't be that person who does. Oh, that's the girl who got raped. And now having comments like, that's true. And you now create, if one person speaks out, we heard it having cases of underreported rape.
Yeah.
In our society, what we're supposed to be doing is to encourage people that have been raped to actually speak out. You're not going to speak out if you know that when you go to the police station, you're going to be asked, what were you wearing? You're going to be asked, what were you doing there? As a citizen of the country of Nigeria, we all have a right to work ever wherever it is you want to be. All right, and that's a response from our system. So from the police officers actually being retrained in how to deal with human beings. You're not dealing with a teddy bear. You're not dealing with a piece of cloth. You're dealing with someone that has feelings. Someone doesn't come to you needing help, all
right? Right.
Coming to you and then you attack the person.
And you think in your mind.
The so-called first, you're the first respondent. And that's the same way, the energy. Most people, just from that point, I could say, I don't want to push for this case anymore. And that's it. And they just keep it moving. And also, it's a question of us as a society choosing, all right? Taking a mental shift. It's got to be conscious. That you're not going to be that person who is going to actually make the victim feel bad, feel terrible, and yet protect the rapist. And yet, you're saying something else with your mouth, and then in action, you're doing something else. That's right. We've got to make a change.
All right, okay? Let me just remind viewers. So if you are having that urge to want to rape somebody, let me tell you that as of 2010, I don't know if that's been amended now, especially the Lagos state. If you're caught raping, if you're judged to have raped somebody, you'll be punished. You'll be imprisoned for 14 years in prison.
And I actually think that's too little.
A lot of people have questioned that it's quite minimum. It's
really too little.
Don't let me know, you'll be spending 14 of your life in jail for having raped.
How about life? Life to death. I mean, capital punishment is still legal in Nigeria.
Well, that,
life
that,
to
that,
death.
That now,
life imprisonment or death is what
well,
should,
that,
it should
that,
be.
That now we leave to those making the law, right? So now let's quickly move on to... now, we know that there's a lot of things that happen to the victim slash survivor that gets raped. What are the things that, you know, what are the things, the after effect of this on them? Like, having experience that kind of sad incident to be raped, and now let's also add it that it might actually happen by the person they are closest to, somebody they've given their hearts to, somebody they trust entirely, and having the person to mess that all up. What do you think can happen to such a person?
It's the effect of rape. I don't think it can even be quantified. It's just so much from physical to psychological, to gynecological, perhaps. In this case, yeah, same thing as physical. You're talking about bleeding, you're talking about infection. The risk of infection is really high because I don't think there's any rapist who is actually thinking of the well-being of the person is raping the victim.
Right?
So you're not thinking about protection. You don't give a hoot, whatever
how
it is that you're carrying and all of that stuff. So you don't think of affecting or causing undue harm, like harm that you cannot quantify, from having vaginitis. Like, there's so much, from infection to hypersexual desire or disorder. You're having tear, you're having the person feeling nervous, walking around people. Now, the psychological effects, you're having the person feeling scared, having going into depression, anxiety.
Yeah.
The list is endless, it's long, and it's beyond unfortunate.
Like a lady. Recently, we got talking about all of this, and she was telling me that while she was in school, under level, right? She was not raped, right? But an attempt to be raped, right? It was an attempt on her to, somebody wanted to try to force himself on her. She said ever since that incident, like she can't take the picture of her head, of her mind, and she can't stay alone ever again with a guy.
Look
like,
at that. That's something that she's going to have to live with.
She doesn't trust a man again. She can't do it now. Like you said, like some of the things, and I want us to quickly talk about this, touch it more emphatically. Pregnancy, right, is one of the things that can happen when somebody gets raped. Now imagine if 15 years old, 16 years old, just growing up, wanting to make something out of her life, and she got raped, and one of the leading result is that she gets pregnant. Please, how do you want this kind of girl to, I mean, come out of this as a better person? Because first, even people that get pregnant without having been raped, we know the stigma some of them go through, because people keep pointing fingers at them that this and this happened to you. Now, who do you want to tell a story to?
Well, that's the part of, as a society, we've got to make a mental shift, like I said. So it's already, the person's already dealing, the lady's already in question, is already dealing with so much. Then you've got a life inside of you. You've got an innocent baby inside of you. You're a kid yourself, and you're having to raise another child. That's hard, to say the very least. But that's where family comes in. That's where society comes in. We need to come together. The family of the lady in question now, I've got to come together and help her walk through it and make sure she gets help. So not just seeing a gynecologist, seeing a regular doctor. That's the part where a psychiatrist comes in. That's the part where a psychologist perhaps comes in, because you've got to walk through it so she doesn't pass that pain, that hate. Because I don't think you're going to be thinking of a rapist, someone who raped you with glowing terms, or you're going to be thinking of them with favor. So you don't pass that hate to the kid, and and just basically being able to walk through it. And there are a lot of bodies in Nigeria right now, a lot of NGOs who actually provide help, that's a part of healing. Actually, that's where healing comes in, where you actually have people who have also gone through the same thing. We can also be like a bonding process or a healing process. You have people who have walked through this and they are better for it. They've grown, they've been able to heal and grow. Then having to have people like this to also guide you through the process, because to say it's hard is a massive understatement.
All right. So like Labaka rightly said, that I think for people who have gone through this, especially for those that this led to them having to have a baby when, I mean, they least expected it, but rape, right? So I think it's just for us to show them a lot of love and make them believe that they can still make something out of their life and just walk through it. And I also like the part where you have that I think there should be a community where people come out to speak, you know, to encourage folks who are going through it, people who have, I mean, experienced this themselves, you know, just coming up to encourage them and, you know, get them through that phase of their life. All right, now let's quickly see how people can prevent rape. Like, I mean, ladies, now let's narrow it down to the ladies. What do you think can be done? Must you work with a gun? Right? Or what should we do to, now I'm only talking now as a brother, what should I tell my sister? Like, okay, these are the things you need to do, these are the things you need to have with you while you're working, these are the observation you have to, these are things you're looking out for while you're working. Like, if you see somebody coming behind you, you know, what are the things we need to tell the young ladies out there? Like, okay, well, these are things you need to do to prevent rape.
I think the ladies already have so much to do already, and it's not fair that we've got to add more. I think we already have more than enough to do already. And I say this because it's not the fault nobody deserves to be raped. No one asked to be raped. No one, regardless of what they wear, how they talk, where the vicinity where they are, we've got to educate our boys. We spend, as a society, we spend so much time training our girls, and we leave our boys to roam. That's not how it should be. Train your boys. Teach your boys not to rape. Teach your son not to rape. Understand that you don't have a right over another woman's body. All right, no is no, and that's it. Consent should be something that should be taught from a very young age. From tugging at someone's hair to pulling at someone's pigtails, no is no. Don't touch someone's body. Now, for women, I think as much as you and I know that it's not our fault, we don't ask to be raped. Nobody enjoys being raped. All right, it's nobody's fault except the perpetrator, except the rapist. It's just that person's fault. That's actually the person to blame. We've also got to be conscious and be security conscious. If you're walking around at night, make sure that you're holding a key, at least a key. There's a way you hold a key. Yes, and if in the event if anything of such does happen, you can at least make at least cause a distraction or a hurt on the perpetrator, and then you can then run. You're not standing to fight. I don't think you can handle.
You don't stand.
Yeah, except you're actually trained, which is part where self-defense classes also comes in. So we should also learn the couple of exercises like that on YouTube. How you can get out of certain holds.
Yeah,
you can hear and all of that. From carrying your own pepper spray, the pepper spray is too. The pepper spray is around. It's the Nigerian police actually say we're not supposed to be carrying it. But hey, you and I, we're the first. We are our own first responders.
You're the receiving,
yeah, exactly.
Receiving
we're our own first responders. So yes, make sure you can make your locally made
pepper spray
at home. There are ways to actually make it. Google it. From your Cameroon pepper to your Ataro dough, there are ways you blend it and mix and match. And then you're going to have a perfect and effective weapon over anyone who's actually coming to you. But the point is, you're not standing to fight. You just want to get
escape,
away.
Right.
Find a way to get away. So let's learn self-defenses. But there's so much we teach our girls to do. Not to sit in a particular way. We should always cross our legs. Come on now. Let's train our boys. That's the most fitting one. Teach your boys. Educate your boys. Educate our men. From having walks to having sensitization. A couple of weeks ago,
right.
weeks or months ago, actually, earlier this year, there was the walk across the market. I can't remember the name tag now, but I remember that I was such a huge... I wasn't able to be a part of the walk, but from retweeting to resourcing from my friends who could be there, there was a walk in the marketplace where it was about... A lot of people now struggle for me now. There's certain markets in Lagos. No matter how nice what they are selling is, I don't go there. Because from your shirt being tugged, if you're not careful, they can actually tear your clothes.
Yeah, that's true.
Tugging you, it starts from there. That's where it starts from. So from that education, from schools, let's start teaching our boys from home. From your cousin to your nephews to your nieces, our girls also understanding what consent is. I think that's where the solution starts from. And call the police. Call the police and get the authorities involved.
Great. So having heard all of these, I just need to chip in that if it's very important that you need to step out of your house or wherever you are at night, try your possible best to at least get somebody go out with you if it's getting very late, because it is getting really, really ridiculous how it's unsafe out. So you alone going out at night, you know, it opens you up to risks of, you know, having people want to attack you, because they don't see, okay, this is a young pretty lady working by herself at night, and they see you as a prey. So if you have somebody working with you, probably a big brother or your uncle, beg them, if it's very important that you go out at night,
absolutely, to chip in there as well.
It's not just stay back home, you know.
Our government also has to come in. Our lawmakers have also got to come in. 14 years? For what? It's got to be harder. It's got to be more stringent. It's death to life. That should be it.
That's what I was saying.
They can do castration as well, if that will work.
We leave this to the policymakers. That's the legislators, right? So I think a lot has to be done. I'm not saying the 14 years is sufficient.
I'm not saying because a lot
of people get it's just 14 years, like, yeah, and come. And there's this law of also for juveniles, right? They say, okay, because you're still under age, there's a little we can do to punish you, right? We'll not take you to and train you and tell you, like you rightly said, education needs, like, I saw a trending video online where about a little school, they had this song taught to their children, how that once anybody, whoever the person who is not your father, your mother, touches your private part, report immediately. Like, don't let anybody from, you know, wanting to use their elbow to touch your body and so, stop it immediately. Let the person know affirmatively that you don't like this.
Let me show you tell your parents.
You know, some people say the way she was telling me that she doesn't like it was not fair.
No, I know something like a yes. What's in the heavens is that?
So things like that. And, you know, a lot of things need to be put in place to just make this look really, really very serious. Because it sounds like a joke, said, it was attempt to rape. And, we don't do this again. You go scot-free.
No, it's got to be stringent laws and stringent punishment measures.
A lot needs to be put. Even banners on the road, on the roadside, people seeing this on a daily basis, reminding them that, see, you also have a child one day. You know, like... things like this, so we keep it in the back of our mind. We remind ourselves continually that we have a lot to do, you know, to minimize all of these bad things happening around. And it's people doing this,
human beings. And I think on the last note, my last nugget I'm going to drop is the fact that a man is a man, all right, and he's a human being. is not, you don't have to wait that is someone's brother, someone's son, someone's friend before you actually treat people like human beings.
Right.
A woman is a human being, right? You don't have to think that she's someone's sister, someone's daughter, someone's child. She's a human being first. Treat people fairly, kindly. I don't think anybody enjoys being raped. So why do you rape people? Why?
And that's a big question. I mean, it's just, it beats my imagination. I try to think about it, what is the reason? Because there are a whole lot of ways to do whatever you want to do without having to affect somebody else's life for the negative. I mean, it is really ridiculous to say. I think this is a question we need to have more of this, how to prevent things to do to checkmate people doing this, and even having community police having to parade, you know, all those empty streets where a lot of people don't work, you know, things like that. A lot of this we need to talk. But this is the much we can take on the show. There's a lot to say, right? But I think there's the lot we can take on the show, guys. So, guys, let's keep this going, right? Let's keep this conversation going offline on all of our social media handles, on Facebook, TikTok, YouTube, Instagram, on our WhatsApp number, right? So just let's keep this conversation going. And also do your own best, your own quarter, all right, to see that we prevent this from happening outside. When you hear people talking, don't be the one to point fingers at them and talk trash. You understand? Try your best, because this can happen to anybody, right? So guys, that's the much we can take on the show. So Labaka, I say a very big thank you for being a part of the show today.
Thank you so much for having me on your show.
Thank you very much, guys. So guys, still will come your way next time. It's still your show, Gender Equality. We tend to talk about things that are sensitive to us, things that people don't want to talk about. We'll talk about them right here and try to educate everyone, even ourselves that we're talking. We tend to learn right from ourselves and get to better ourselves. So that's one of the aim of the show, is to better ourselves and better our viewers. Remember, we have wonderful content for you on all of our shows, right, from gender equality to sport analysis and the rest of them. All right, big shout out to everybody behind the scene making the show a wonderful one. We'll say thank you and God bless you. All right, guys, we're coming away next time. It's still CTV. Stay loved on this online streaming channel. God bless you.